This is finally my personal collection video. And before I start, I'm going to explain that this is going to be a three-part video. I just can't fit everything into a single video. So, one of the videos will include all of my boxes that I really, really like to collect because of the really nice artwork that's on the top of the boxes. This one's from Morning Tide, but we'll look at all the other boxes later. Another video I'm also going to go over my magic cube that I've been putting together for not a very long time, but maybe over a year or so. There's a lot of cards that we're putting here. So this is going to be one video. But of course, we have to start with the binder. And the binder that I use for my collection is the 4 binder, the 4 2.0 binder, and this is by Deck Tutor. It's a really, really, really beautiful binder because it can really showcase all of your cards that you've always wanted to have them when they're in their sets of 4. So we're going to start at the back of the page, working ourselves to the front, where I believe the front will have the most interesting cards. This is the back page. We have very classic cards like Hypnotic Spectres, Lightning Bolts, and Swords to Plowshares. I'm sure you know what card this is, but if you don't, Hypnotic Spectre, 1 and 2 black, Summon Spectre, Flying. An opponent damaged by Spectre must discard a card at random from his or her hand. Ignore this effect if opponent has no cards left in hand. There was no trace of aught on that illumined face. Samuel Coleridge, Phantom. So oftentimes you'll have a first turn, Swamp, Dark Ritual, Hypnotic Spectre, and that was a very fearsome. Lightning Bolt, 1 red, lightning bolt deals 3 damage to target player, creature, or player. Christopher Rush, who recently passed away. Very classic card. Swords to Plowshares. 1 white. Instant. Target creature is removed from game entirely. Creature's controller gains point life points equal to creature's power. The artwork on that card often is interesting. Understand it. Moving over here, we have some interesting cards as well. Let's start this time at the top. We have this card, Ball Lightning. Triple red, summon Lightning can attack the turn it comes into play. At the end of any turn, bury Ball Lightning. 6-1. So this card was played not that much, but it was still a fearsome card. It was unfortunate that a black knight or a white knight is able to stifle that card. This card does. Well, here we go. 1 and a white. Sorcery. Whichever player has more lands in play must discard enough lands of his or her choice to equalize the number of lands both players have in play. Next, equalize the cards in hand, and then creatures in play the same way. Creatures lost in this manner are considered buried. This card is said to be the most imbalanced card. It's absolutely broken and super powerful. Yet it's called balance. Just want to show you what it's like when you have 8 of them sort of lined up in the same row. Alright, at the bottom here, I have a few interesting cards, and you'll see why. It's an Italian card. I believe it's called Thunder Spirit, so it's 1 and 2 white, and I believe it has flying first strike, and he's at 2-2. Over here we have a Leviathan, 5 and 4 blue. And this is also, actually, I think this one's French. this one here, and this one's in Japanese. Can't remember what this one was called. I think it started with an X. Maybe someone in the comments can remember what card that is. And there's this one here, which is also Japanese. And this one is Urim Dijin 3 and a green. I forgot what Urim Dijin does at the moment. The sword. I love this artwork so much more than the other one. Let me just go over some cards of every page, not every. Dream Halls, 3 and 2 blue. Enchantment. Instead of paying the casting cost for a spell of any color, its caster may choose and discard a card that shares at least one color with that spell. If the spell has X in its casting cost, then X is 0. Within, without, Dream Halls. I think this card is supposed to be pretty good in ETH or Commander, but I have yet to use it. Helm of Obedience, 4 colorless artifact. It's a lot of text. I'm not gonna read it, but the funny story is I had at 4 of these cards, and at the time they were just junk rare. And then there was a combo, Helm of Obedience, and I think it's, I forgot which card, but it, all of a sudden, Helm of Obedience just skyrocketed in price because of the combo. It's not Painter's Servant Stone combo. It's something else. Alright, let's go right to this one here. This one is a card I've had for a while now. Berserk. 1 green. Instant. Until end of turn, target creature's current doubles and gains trample ability. If it attacks, target creature is destroyed at the end of turn. This spell cannot be cast after current turn's attack is completed. So, it was a really strong card. If you had a 5/5 creature, he immediately turned into a 10/10 creature. Your opponent is wondering, huh, that game was fast. have some cards from the vault. Let me go over a dark ritual. Probably a card that I've played many times when I was young. Obviously not this copy, but this dark ritual is really nice. Instant. Add 3 black to your mana pool. Lashrak, my liege. Grant me the power I am due. Limduel, the necromancer. So you can imagine, 1 black can yield you 3 black. You get the mana acceleration, but you lose the card advantage. Let's go to this card up in this corner. Cruel ultimatum. 2 blue, 3 black, and 2 red. Sorcery. Target opponent sacrifices a creature. Discards 3 cards and loses 5 life. You return a creature card from your graveyard to your hand. Draw 3 cards and then gain 5 life. There is always a greater power. I believe this is Nicobolas as the dragon, and it could be Sargon Vol right there. It's a really good card, but has a really high casting cost. Legendary land. Each land is a swamp in addition to its other types. Yawgmoth's corpse is a wound in the universe. His foul blood seeps out, infecting the land with his final curse. Lord Windgrace. I think this was a popular card. I just never use it. So these two pages were the From the Vault series. So this one was From the Vault 20. And then this one was From the Vault Realms. And there's a few cards missing from both. I think I've sold a few of them on eBay. This page is currently vacant, and I'll be populating it maybe pretty soon. Here we go. Just some of the cards that I've opened on the channel. Some Eldrazi cards and some of the cards from Battle for Senegar. This one's Inverter of Truth and Eldrazi Mimic. If you want to see those cards, you can check out the videos that I have of unboxing or opening Battle for Zendikar. This is one I haven't showed on the channel. Sunforger. 3 casting cost artifact equipment. Equipped creature gets +4/+0. Then, red and a white, unattached Sunforger. Search your library for a red or white instant card with converted mana cost 4 or less, and play that card without playing its mana cost. Then shuffle your library. Equip 4/3. So it's an interesting card. I have a few of these, and so I use one in one of my tiny leaders decks. And over here we have some cards. Nothing that I want to go over. Everything's kind of this page. We have this is a Chinese Prophet of Grufix, 3 and a green and a blue, and I decided to buy these and hope that they would go up in price, but then of course they banned it. Legendary creature, Sliver. Sliver creatures you control have indestructible. This is the source, the line unbroken since the calamity that brought such monsters to our shores. Astrid, Thunian Scout. 5/5. In the binder because I don't have a sliver deck. No sliver deck yet. Everyone has one, I think. Some cards that I've gone over in my channel. Maybe not this one. And Siamede, one, a red and a white. This one's foil. I think I went over the non-foil version. Anyways, legendary creature, human soldier, first strike, vigilance, heroic. Whenever you cast a spell that targets Annex and Siamede, creatures you control get +1/+1, and gain trample until end of turn. Akros' greatest heroes are also its royalty. 3/2. I love the foiling on some of the cards. I think the first time I saw a foil card was, I think, a body snatcher, and then my friend showed it to me, and I was so young and I was so blown away by it. It was amazing. Yeah, on this page there should have been like 4 Lightning Helix, 4 Boros Charm, and 4 Gaze of Granite, but there were 2 in one of my decks. Lightning Helix, classic card, red and a white, instant. Lightning Helix deals 3 damage to target creature, and you gain 3 life. Rage is not the answer. Rage followed by fitting vengeance is the answer. A Johnny. Yeah. So those are some Boros charms in there. And here, let's go over these two. Well, they're the same card, but one is the promotional and one was the regular. Let's do this one. Supreme Verdict. One, two white and a blue. That artwork looks pretty epic as it is. Sorcery. Supreme Verdict can't be countered. Destroy all creatures. Leonos had no second thoughts about the abolishment edict. He'd left sky runes, warnings of eviction, even though it was cloudy. So this is the original pack from, I think, Return to Ravnica. Anyways, the promotional one. Supreme Verdict. Yeah, it's pretty nice. Although the artwork on the other one is really nice as well. The same. Yeah, I absolutely love this binder. It has side loading pockets, but unfortunately, you can't take out the pages. Fortunately, there's a version now where you can take in and out of the pockets. Up here is a circle helm smasher, but I already went over that in one of my unpacking and unboxing videos. I did not go over this one though. Aurelia the War Leader. Two red and two white. Legendary creature. Angel. Flying, vigilance, haste. Whenever Aurelia, the war leader, attacks for the first time each turn, untap all creatures you control. After this phase, there is an additional combat phase. Where Razia was aloof and untouchable, Aurelia is on the front lines calling for war. Which one do I want to go over? How about this one? Stone Forge Mystic. One and a white creature. Core Artificer. When Stone Forge Mystic enters the battlefield, you may search your library for an equipment card. Reveal it. Put it into your hand. Shuffle your library. One, a white and tap. You may put an equipment card from your hand onto the battlefield. One, two. This was the Vancouver GP 2016 promotional card. And a lot of people were excited to have it. In fact, they were hoping for Stoneforge Mystic to be unbanned from Modern. Most of these cards I've gone over on my channel. This one's interesting. It's a Russian card. Oh, the name of this card just slips my mind right now, but I was so excited to get a Russian mythic. It's too bad this wasn't a, money card. Those Russian foils, the really money ones, they could be extremely expensive. Let's see. Sure, let's go for this one. Hypnotic siren, a blue enchantment creature siren, bestow 4/5 and 2 blue, flying. You control enchanted creature. Enchanted creature gets +1/+1, and has flying. It's 1/1. It's a nice foily card. I bought 4 of those, possibly thinking that they might go up in price. Here we have a non-foil version, and I have a foil version, so let's go with the non-foil version. Shore Crasher Elemental, 3 blue. Creature Elemental. Exile Shore Crasher Elemental. Then return it to the battlefield face down under its owner's control. Shore Crasher Elemental gets +1/-1 or -1/+1 until end of turn. Megamorph. 4 and a blue, 3/3, and so I opened this last year in a pack, and I also opened its foil in the next pack. So if I held on to these cards, I'm thinking maybe they'll be used in modern decks, and then the price could go up. Clone Legion, 7/2 blue. Sorcery. For each creature target player controls, put a token onto the battlefield that's a copy of that creature. Their lust for battle was so great that they didn't care. Their enemies wore their own faces. Clone Legion. So, with 9 mana, you can have the same creatures as your opponent. Or at least one of your opponents. Target creature in your graveyard with total casting cost 3 or less and put that creature into play. Cycling for 2. It's a nice card. And oftentimes the older foils, something about them. And so this page, I guess the bottom, trying to collect some of the older foils. Smother, 1/1. Instant. Destroy target creature with converted mana cost 3 or less. It can't be regenerated. I can't hear them scream, but at least I don't have to listen than beg. Phage the untouchable. I think Phage wants to hear them scream. So sadistic. There's another foreign card. And I'm thinking of doing some ASMR videos with foreign language, but just give me some time. I have to really plan it out and purchase the packs. I forgot what card this was. I'm not sure. Sandstep Mastodon, and I'll show you the English and the Chinese. It's like that. Maybe you're wondering if I could speak Chinese. I can speak a little bit of Chinese, but in terms of reading it, no, I can't. So. This one is Korean. It's this card is right into being. Four and two green. I think it's search your library for two creature cards. Put them into your hand. But if you have a creature with more than four power. No, I probably butchered that. I'm sorry. I'm sure someone could correct me. This is Hooded Hydra. And it comes into play with X plus one counters on it. And if Hooded Hydra goes to the graveyard, you get that many, you get 1/1 creatures for that many plus one counters. Let's see what we have here. Yep, another foreign card. This is, Alesha, who smiles at death. First strike. Whenever she attacks, you may pay. I think this is... Oh, I forgot. okay. White, black. And if you do, you can get a creature casting three or less and put it into play. Also attacking. I have a bunch of monastery swift spears. There's a funny story that I may have in a future video that I'm planning to call flashback videos, where I go back and explain some stories that I've had. But the story goes, there was someone online who was selling foil monastery swift spears for like an insanely dirt cheap price, and I went to go buy them, and he had even more cards to give me, and I just felt kind of, I don't know, dishonest. But I purchased the cards and I flipped them right away. And so this one, Dragon Whisperer, was the very, very, very first card I've ever unpacked on my channel. Actually, when I opened it, I was like, oh, I really wanted to get that on camera. So I put the cards back into the wrapping, and I tried to make it look like it wasn't opened yet, and I grabbed my phone camera, and I started shooting, and that's how it all started. Just some lands here, some wedge lands. Maybe I'll go over this one. Dust Bowl land. Add one colorless mana to your mana pool. Sacrifice a land. Destroy target non-basic land. I bought that recently. I was thinking that it might go up in price, but it hasn't. I make it sound like I'm a terrible magic financer, but I'm not bad. I recently scored on a few things, and I'll show you them later. This is Plains from Beta. Tap to add white to your mana pool. Let's see the illustrator. Jesper. Mirror Force. It's the only beta card that I have. I think this one is a misprint, so let me see if I can get that on camera. It's a basic forest from Champions of Kamigawa, but just this line here, I think you can see that the artwork's just a little bit messed up. I don't know, but maybe I'm wrong. Maybe they all look like this. But you know, you can sort of see from here to up here, just the ink just crapped out or something. That's what I think. So yeah, I know that misprints and rarities they're sometimes sought after by the magic community. So should always keep your misprints and things like that. You might be thinking they're garbage, but there's value out there. This is a Korean foil swamp that I got, and it's from Cons of Tarkir. It's really nice. I like foreign cards. I like foil. And this is just a foil mountain. English. Alright, we're at some more juicier cards. Let me start with lowest price first. This is a foil Bloodstained Mire to land. Tap to pay one life. Sacrifice Bloodstained Mire. Search your library for a swamp or mountain card and put it onto the battlefield. Then shuffle your library. Where dragon lions once triumphed, their bones now molder. I think this card is worth close to $50, I think. I'm not sure. I have not checked. Not checked prices recently. This one here. Windswept heath. Land. Basically the same thing as the bloodstained mire. Where dragons once roared, their bones now keen. This one you can search for a forest and plains card. Also foil. I haven't checked the prices, but I think this one is close to 50 as well. Wooded foothills. You can search for a mountains or forest card. Where dragon's breath once burned, their bones now freeze. In the wooded foothills. The artwork is just absolutely fantastic on these fetch lands. Flooded strand. You can search for a plains or island card. Where dragons once slept, their bones now rest. I think this one is up to $80 or $90. Not sure. Arid Mesa. Search for a mountain or plains card. There's no flavor text on this one. It was from Zendikar, from a different set. This one I think is worth similar, about like $80 or $90 just for one card. Absolutely incredible. And now, for my most cherished possession, or one of. This looks like a regular island to you, but it is not. It is probably the most sought after island, or one of. This is a guru island. Check it out. How much this card is worth. And it will leave you just so shocked to know what this card is worth. Share you the story of this card. A long time ago, I purchased a collection from my older sister's boyfriend, and he came and he showed me all his cards, and I purchased it. And I thought all the good cards I've sifted through. And then I put the rest of the junk in my garage. In my garage. Fast forward, like 4 years. I just looked at it again. And I looked at that island. And I did just a little bit of research. And I was floored to know that there was such value just sitting there in my garage. this is a foil underground river from 7th edition. It's considered a pain land where you can tap to add blue or black. And so I've recently purchased this at a price of, I think, like $19. And then overnight, it went up to about $39. It was due to all the Eldrazi cards that needed colorless mana. And so the Painlands now produced not only your two colors, but it also gave you the colorless mana. So in essence, it was like a triple color land. Something that not very many cards can give you. And so I knew that cards, the pain land cards, would have gone up in price. So I bought out, you know, a few of them here and there. And this is the blue green one, the Yavimaya Coast. Yep, and there's a few here and there. Here are the full art basic lands from the recent set. Here I have four flooded strands, non-foil, four polluted deltas. Let me bring it closer. Just love this binder. It can just showcase the cards that you love. Windswept Heaths, four footed foothills, four bloodstained mire. Just absolutely amazing. This binder. We have Shocklands now. These are steam vents. They come into play and you can take two damage to untap them. Let me read the flavor text on this one. Crafted with genius, energized with madness. This artwork is different than this one here. This one is really bad quality. I think someone will, like, put it in their washer dryer or something. The two artworks right here. Four steam vents, and we got two here, so that's six. More shock lands, hollowed fountains, watery graves, some other lands here. Let me show this one. Watery grave. Let me read the flavor text. I fear that as we scurry after phantoms, the Tamir pull nine puppet strings. That's interesting. I wish I knew more about the lore and the story sometimes. Hallowed Fountain. A place to relax if you have the proper permit. Certainly, it is a wonderful place to relax. What do we have here? Just all the shock lines that I have. Godless Shrine. Judgment without hope. It's a godless shrine. Temple Garden. In the gardens of the Conclave, order and beauty are the roots of power. appears a blood crypt. Sure, I'll go over it. Alright. People are hanging there. Where the dead serve as diversion, decor, and dessert. Charted depths, unbounded hopes, unfathomable mysteries. I'm not sure what I'm looking at right now. I'm guessing it's just, you know, a pool of different things. Alright. Page now, and I want you to look at the cards very, very carefully. Let's start with this one. Black Lotus, zero casting cost, mono artifact, adds three mana of any single color of your choice to your mana pool, then is discarded. Tapping this artifact can be played as an interrupt. This card is not a real card. It is a proxy card that someone honest, I made this card, and I really liked doing some arts and crafts recently, and I went on a proxy making rampage, and so it's a card that I don't sell, and I don't profit from them. I just make it because first, and they look amazing. I sometimes play with them in a few casual decks. Black Lotus. Every Magic player's dream. And I have two of them. What else do we have here? Mox Emerald. You might be wondering, is it easy to make these cards? How did I make them? Things like that. It's a pretty long process. It took me some time to really perfect it. But if I could do it, I think anyone else of you can do it. galaxy of, you know, $1, $2 cards. They're absolutely beautiful, these proxy cards. You can make them borderless, and it's just absolutely amazing. You can see on the bottom of these proxies it says not for sale. And at the top, Tarmogoyf. Creature. Tarmogoyf's power is equal to the number of card types among all graveyards, and its toughness is equal to that number, plus one. Though primal, it has been known to adapt to the strangest of garbage people throw away. So I have four of those, two Black Lotuses, and one of each Mox. So yeah, I do make proxies, and you can make it look like anything. Just look at this one. Arrest. So the casting costs two and a white. Arrest. Enchantment aura. Enchant creature. Enchant creature can't attack or block, and its activated abilities can't be activated. Sorry, Mr. J. Harley Quinn from the DC universe. One of I guess the Joker's not really sidekick, but one of the Joker's lackeys or minions, right? That's such an awesome card. And the one I snuck out earlier is Chandra, Pyromancer. This is a proxy card. This is not real. It's trying to look like the promotional cards from the, I think, San Diego Comic Con. Yeah, so it's really nice. Anyways, I hope you guys liked watching this video of my personal collection. Thanks for watching the entire thing. And in the future, there's just more of my collection. There's just more of my collection, so I'll upload those videos. And yeah, thank you so much for supporting my channel. Please like and subscribe. Comment below, and I'll reward you guys for watching it this far with some ASMR triggers. Thank you, guys.